a psychological thriller produced by Filipinos find its way into streaming. Catlea Killer joins hundreds of Filipino shows and films on Prime Video. But its cast members say their genre makes the series more exciting for viewers who are growing tired of mushy tales and movie tropes.
It's unpredictable. That's okay. What I love about it. Even if you see in the trailer already or you know sa aking mga kamay, hindi mo pa rin mahuhulaan yung mga next few na mangyayari. Even if you watch episode 1 and then 2 and then you, okay, I think I know where the story is going, you're wrong.
Romance and comedy aren't really universal. If you really think about it, there's some jokes that don't translate.
Yeah,
diba? You read the subtitles and you're like, parang that's not what the joke was.
Yeah.
So yun, parang it's more... It's easier to market internationally. And I think that's also what makes the show different. Na we're trying our hand in paving the way for other Filipino content.
Catlea Killer follows the intriguing investigation on a slew of cryptic murders by the copycat of an infamous serial killer. It is also a spin-off of a classic 90s Filipino film, Sa Aking Mga Kamay. Several historical mansions now open to the public thanks to a program which seeks to give a more in-depth understanding of the country's past leaders and heritage. Katrina Domingo tells us about the Malacañang Heritage Tours.
After several centuries since these mansions were built across Malacañang, its doors are now open to the public to give visitors a glimpse of powerful figures who may have walked its halls decades ago. The conversion of these mansions into museums and cultural venues are part of the government's Malacañang Heritage Tours, a program of First Lady Liza Marcos, which seeks to restore and rehabilitate these real estates and turn them into attractions with free entrance to the public.
It is now open to the public. I invite everyone to come enjoy. Puntahan ninyo, lalo na yung ating mga estudyante. I am inviting everyone to come and get, if you are in this part of the city, to come and visit it. I think it's very educational.
So far, the properties included in the Malacañang Heritage Tours include the Teus Mansion, the Goldenberg Mansion, and the Bahay Ugnayan. The Teus Mansion, once owned by Valentin Teus, the former Primera de Alcalde of the Ayuntamiento de Maynila, is now a museum for past presidents of the Philippines. Its lower level was divided into several rooms that showcased the history, achievements, and even some hobbies of previous Philippine presidents, from Emilio Aguinaldo to Rodrigo Duterte. Aside from their life stories, each exhibit also features some of their personal belongings, like Corazon Aquino's hand-painted bag and Joseph Ejercito Estrada's iconic wristband and ashtray. A gallery inside the Teus Mansion is dedicated to the former first ladies of the country. Meanwhile, the Bahay Ugnayan, which used to be the Presidential Complaint Center, now serves as the museum for the current chief executive. Visitors will be welcomed by one of the red pickup vehicles President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. used as his campaign float last year. A souvenir shop also sells BBM's campaign memorabilia for supporters who missed their chance to grab these during the campaign rally. Marcos Jr.'s life story is sprawled on the Bahay Ugnayan's second floor. Photos of the president's childhood, adolescence, and other highlights of his life are shown in photos and installations, including Marcos Jr.'s acceptance letter and special diploma from the Oxford University, one of the issues hurled against him during the campaign period. The EDSA People Power Revolution, which forced the Marcos family to flee the country, is included in the exhibit through an installation that shows a yellow ribbon tied around a barbed wire. In another part of the Bahay Ugnayan is a stack of papers, part of Marcos Jr.'s electoral protest against Lenny Robredo's vice presidential win in 2016. Items used in Marcos Jr.'s vlogging are also showcased in the museum to give the public a glimpse of what he was doing, especially at the height of the COVID-19 pandemic. Other campaign materials and gifts are also displayed in the museum. The Goldenberg Mansion, on the other hand, will be used as a venue for cultural and heritage exhibitions. The Presidential Communications Office said in a statement that the Malacañang Heritage Tours is designed to encourage the public to appreciate previous leaders of the Philippines. The Malacañang Heritage Mansions are open every Tuesday to Sunday from 9 a.m. to 4 p.m. Guided tours are available upon request. Katrina Domingo, ABS-CBN News.
An update on the weather now. All wind signals in the Philippines now lifted as Betty continues to weaken. Weather Bureau Pagasa downgraded Betty's status to a severe tropical storm Thursday. It was last spotted off Itbayat in Batanes Province with peak winds of up to 100 kilometers per hour and gusts of up to 125 kilometers per hour. Betty is forecast to move northeastward and exit the Philippine area of responsibility this afternoon. But Pagasa says the southwest monsoon will continue to bring winds and rains in some parts of the country. The U.S. and Taiwan set to sign the first deal under a new trade framework. Both governments said the first agreement will be signed in Washington Thursday morning. Last month, the two sides agreed on the first deal, which covers customs and border procedures as well as regulatory practices. After this is signed, talks will start on more complicated trade areas, including agriculture and digital trade. The framework is expected to further boost ties between the two at a time of heightened tensions with China. After months of haggling and resistance from hardline Republicans, the U.S. House of Representatives officially passed the debt ceiling deal as lawmakers race to prevent a catastrophic default. The vote, 214 yes, 117 no. The measure would suspend the debt ceiling for 2 years through the next presidential election, along with some modest spending cuts.
Don't mistake it that it's the solution. It's the beginning. And we should wake up the next morning on how we could do better even tomorrow. Runaway spending is making America more dependent on foreign debt holders. The total debt we owe to other countries is $7.4 trillion. Countries like China are buying more of our farmland, more of our businesses, and more of our debt. This is unsustainable, but what's even worse, it is dangerous.
U.S. President Joe Biden lauds the lower chamber's bipartisan compromise. He now urges the Senate to pass the measure as quickly as possible.